March 2011 market report. It's April, but we're going to review the March data and also our year-to-date numbers in all of these categories. So let's get started with new listings on the market. In March was 359. Last March we had 425 homes come on the market, and that is down 16% of the actual inventory coming onto the market during the particular month of March. Year-to-date, we have had 738 so far this year come on the market, versus 905 last year. So year to date, the amount of inventory coming onto the market is down 18% versus last year. Now if we look at the actual homes going under contract, is 188 pended homes so far this year. That was in March, versus 201 last March. So the actual homes going under contract was down 6% in March. Even though we felt a big rush this March, it was not quite what it was last March. The only difference is last March had the assisted market with the home buyer's tax credit. So this is a good sign that we're competing with that market of last year. So year to date, we're actually up. So 400 homes have gone under contract versus 388 last year. So up 3% again versus the market where they had the tax credit to help build the market. So that's a great sign again for our economy. Sold homes, 94. Versus 107, so these are actually homes that actually closed during March. And that is down 12% versus last year. And then we're at year-to-date, 234 homes in Rochester residential have closed versus 237 last year. So almost a mirror image in that number. Again, I can't emphasize that enough, but we are not being assisted with a tax credit this time, and we're competing just as well as we did last year, so that's a great sign. Sold the average days on the market, 148 versus 141, so they are on the market a little bit longer, up 5%. The average sale price in Rochester is 164,240 this year versus 170,163 last year, so down 3.5% on the average sale price. Our active listings, 1588 in 2011 versus 1760 in 2010 through March. Now if we look at sold price versus list price, this is telling us what the original list price was, what price did it actually sell for. So they're saying 95% of that original list price is what it's selling for in 2011 versus 97 in 2010. So you're having to drop the price of that home to get it sold a little bit more in 2011. So that's where it's crucial to price it right off the bat when all that traffic is there. Now if we look at all of Southeast Minnesota. So new listings on the market, 761 versus 1,012 in 2010 during the month of March. So almost 250 homes different versus the previous year, and that's 24% decrease in homes coming on the market in Southeast Minnesota. Year to date, we've had over 1,600 homes hit the market. Last year, year to date, it was at 2,100. So basically 400 homes difference, and that's going to be 25% decrease in homes coming on the market versus the previous year. And a lot of these homes that came on the market last year were coming on the market because of that tax credit, so that's why they have such a big advantage versus this year. Homes under contract, 445 homes have gone under contract in Southeast Minnesota versus 497 last year. So that is down 10% in pended homes. Year to date, 1,019 versus 1,060. So again, very close to last year, and again, I keep saying it, but that tax credit was in effect last year, so that's, again, a great sign. Again, trying to be optimistic and positive, because there is a big shift going on here in the market, and we're kind of feeling it right now, and that's a great sign that we're doing it without the tax credit. Sold homes, 283 versus 315 last year during the month of March, so down 10%. Year-to-date, 723 versus 706, so we're up 2% as a whole in Southeast Minnesota in our actual homes that have closed. Sold average days on the market, 137 versus 135. Very similar to last year, 1.4% difference. Average sale price is 126 versus 134 last year. So we are down 0.26%. Active listings, 4,403 in 2011, 5,119 in 2010. Then our sale price, 94% of the list price in all of Southeast Minnesota versus 95 last year. Again, Rochester was at 95, 97. So all of Southeast Minnesota is 94, 95. Here is the top graph with the blue and the gray. What we're showing here is units that have sold. So blue is 2010, and 2011 is in the dark gray. So this is showing the price point here, how many homes have sold within 100 to 120,000. There's been 19 in 2011 versus 15 in 2010. So you guys can pause this real quick and look at each category. If your house is in that particular market, you can kind of see if it's up or down versus the previous year. And you can see here, the big areas up are in that 100 to 200,000. The gray is 2011 is up in almost all of those areas. Now if we look at the homes coming onto the market, again, gray represents our current year of 2011, and then 2010 is in the maroon. So these are the homes coming on the market. You can see here 120 to 140,000, 78 homes have come on the market so far this year in that price point. So again, you guys can pause that and kind of look at those numbers, find your area, and get that information. So just showing you the trends of where homes are selling and also where they're coming on versus the previous year. Now we're taking a little pie chart here, kind of giving you an idea of what's going on in all those categories. So listed, pended, and sold. In March, 56% of the activity was listings. 221 came on the market. 19% of the activity was sold. So that was 76 that sold. And then pended was 25% of the market, which was 101. If we look at last year, March, 61% of the market was listings coming on. Only 16% was the selling, and then 23% was pending. So more activity is being focused on selling and pending versus the previous year. The previous year there was a lot of homes coming on the market versus this year. This year there's less coming on, but more selling. Now if we look at year to date, this is another sign to see that, again, you've seen it in the previous graphs, the listings are down, but if we look at this, we can see listings 53% versus 60 in 2010. Sold is 18% of the market versus 16, 29 versus 24. So you guys can pause that. And also you guys can come back to ionrochestermarket.com at any time and get the up-to-date market statistics. If you guys have any questions, just email me again, Calvin Mergen at kw.com.